Welcome back. Now, songs of the late reggae legend Lucky Dube continue to get airtime 15 years after his death. Dube was hijacked and shot dead on the 18th of October in 2007 in Johannesburg in the suburb of Rosettenville, shortly after dropping off his two children at their uncle's house.
What could he have done so wrong? Did we even know he was one of your prophets? Listen to his great songs. Oh, Jack, what a man we have lost.
Jamaican reggae group Steel Pulse were preparing for a concert in Abidjan, Ivory Coast.
The loss of Lucky Dube has been a sad loss for African music, world music, black people music, and music general all the way across. It's saddened to know that, you know, such atrocities goes on where, you know, I'd imagine it's black killing black. Our heart goes out to him because we did so many tours with him in the United States.
His death is a big blow, but the fact is, Rasta has never died. We understand our mission, and we rest where we have to go. But I'm sorry for people who think that we are going to react in a certain way and become frightened. On the contrary, we get stronger. By assassinating Lucky Dube, they have made him stronger.
When did you become a Rasta, and why?
I found an encyclopedia that was talking about reggae music and about Rastafarianism. What I read about was Rastafarianism being a way of life, not a religion. And that's what I really liked, just the way of life, you know.
What does it mean to you?
To me, it's about consciousness, be it socially or politically, you know. It's basically consciousness.
Over the years, we've been going there. We develop a relationship with a Aboriginal named Lucky Dube, who use reggae music to project its message of hope and salvation. We develop a kind of friendship. Lucky Dube, you know. Those kind of experience give you a kind of nearness and a kinship with the brethren. I was in England and I was going on the stage, and just as I was about to go on the stage, somebody called me and said, guess what? Them shot Lucky Dube. I said, them kill Lucky Dube. Them say, yeah, them kill Lucky Dube. And right away, I feel so distressed. We went on the stage and all we could talk about was Lucky Dube. It's the only, what would I call, non-Jamaican who continuously use reggae music, because you have other artists, Alpha Blondy and, you know, Salif Keita. But Lucky Dube only use reggae music. And it give him a space in the hearts of the Jamaican people.
Rastafari, look around and tell me what you see.
Look around. Rasta most of my life, I mean, never smoke ganja yet. Never, ever, ever. I don't even know if I roll a split. Now, that may sound weird to a man, because basically if a man say, boy, every Rasta smoke ganja. You see me, no way for Rasta, we don't smoke ganja. And most of the Rasta them we come up with never smoke ganja.
The biggest group, the 12 tribe of Israel, them come with a concept where them put Jesus first. Right? Because them say, greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who has this year revealed himself in the personality of Emperor El Selassie the First. Right? All right, so them gone now with the Jesus Christ concept of Haile Selassie. It makes sense talking about Haile Selassie and seeing Haile Selassie as the center of concept. But it don't make sense to say Haile Selassie is Jesus Christ.